first thing that we did actually was to indicate that actually nurses and midwives needed health, infectious health risk allowance. And for some time, I think we've been demanding for that allowance to be introduced. But alas, the government understood us, especially this time of COVID, where our nurses have been affected so much. And you can see that in the civil service, we have only nurses who are working. For them, there's no closure, like the way companies are closing or the way schools have closed. For nurses, they don't close. They are 24 hours, 365 days working. So we justified the introduction of the risk allowance, which was introduced, and in the previous negotiations it was introduced. And it's true to say that it was introduced at a very minimal percentage, of which as a union we would have loved it to be at a higher percentage. But we know that the introduction was done in the previous negotiations, and we hope that as we go in the next negotiations for conditions of service for 2022, we are hoping that that risk allowance can be enhanced. So there are a lot of factors to consider. Of course, the issues of the exposure rate right now, is it, are they highly exposed? And if you look at the ratios, because we are having the population increasing, of course, the net patient ratio is actually also widening. So to reduce that, that's why you are hearing the numbers to be employed. So also look at those fundamentals, and also to get consensus from the rest of the nurses and midwives who are receiving the same allowance, at what percentage, if they want that to be enhanced, then we'll consider that.